Hey guys, it's me, Grayson, and today it's going to be a little bit of a different video. This is going to be a how-to video on how to remove and replace shocks. Now, I'm not going to actually do it because I already did it, which I honestly should have recorded, but too late. But I'll just show you guys the steps you have to take to be able to take them off. So, you're gonna have to raise the back up to where you can take the wheel, pop the wheels off, and then this will sink down. Unbolt this, you'll have to, most likely, sometimes you might not have to, is you're going to need it to jack it up by where the underneath here is, on the bottom radius arm, probably about down there somewhere. Raise that up, you can just enough where you can pop that bolt out, and up top, obviously, you're gonna need to unplug your sensor and take this bolt off, and boom. That's how you take the rear shock off, and it's the exact same thing on the other side. Now, on the front is a little trickier. We're gonna be doing this later. We're gonna be finishing this up. But what you need to do, which you don't necessarily have to, but it makes life much easier, is to tear off this side so that way you can get your arm. I'll show you guys. You can get your arm down in there. If I can zoom in. Well, really, if I move this. But typically, your bolt is going to be right back there. If you barely see it, that's going to be where you get your bolt at. And then, obviously the bottom, you're going to be doing the same thing like you always do. Just, if you have to, raise it up, blah, 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 all that, take the wheels off. And that's pretty much it for the front. You don't, like I said, you don't necessarily have to do this, but it makes life so much easier with this off. Now, for some reason, they're different, because on my, this obviously is my dad's buggy. His has a different play on it. On a friend of ours, his buggy is a 2021 Pro XP, and on the front, it's a little bit more open to where you can get like an extension with a swivel, get right down into the bolt, take it out, boom, you're done. Which is, it's weird, it's how it's different on the two. Is that design is much better, because this is it's a little more difficult. Don't mind the messy garage here. That was just from where we're working on the buggies. And today, my shocks too, they had to be rebuilt. I guess three of them were bad. I got the new shock therapy springs on it. The extra space, or the reservoir caps for more fluid in there, I believe, extra space. Limit straps on mine, same as hit. My shocks look similar to his, except they're just for my buggy. And what's weird, just to let you guys know, the 2022 Polaris Pro XP and the 2021 Polaris Pro XP, the back shocks are the same. The front shocks are for some reason different. And even if like this buggy was made in the end of 2021. The other buggy was made around the beginning of 2021, around March. There's still different part numbers for the shocks. So really, they were the same. We would have just swapped the whole shocks all together. But that's just a reminder, guys. The front shocks on the 2022 and the 2021 are not the same. Only the front ones. The back ones are the same. The front ones are not. So that was just a little bit of a pointer to you guys. But like I said, that's just a quick and easy tutorial on how to remove the rear and front shocks. You know, there's other people out there that make videos and all that. And yes, they're educational. I watched some as well, try to figure out how to take mine off. But I figured I'd give you guys on what we had to do to take my dad's off. And I think that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And my next video will probably be me test driving the buggy down at our property. So I'll see you guys later.